Hi everyone, and welcome to the 6-part educational series. Today we'll be covering gum disease. To watch all the videos before they're released on our channel, make sure to download the My Dental Care app from either the App Store or the Google Play Store. Let's get into it.
In this video, we'll be talking about gum disease and its treatments. If you're here for anything in particular, feel free to skip around using the timestamps on screen now.
You might have heard your dentist say the word dental plaque, but what is it? Well, dental plaque is a sticky, colorless biofilm, which simply means it is a collection of different types of bacteria. It grows on the surfaces of your teeth, gums, and soft tissues.
Its formation is a normal, natural process which cannot be prevented. Just 1 hour after brushing your teeth, millions of these bacteria would have already grown back. So, you may be wondering why even bother brushing your teeth in the first place.
Well, when dental plaque first starts to develop, it's very soft and easy to remove with effective toothbrushing. However, by forgetting to brush twice a day or by missing certain areas with your toothbrush, you're leaving the dental plaque undisturbed. This will allow the bacteria to increase in volume, change, and may lead to gum disease.
Over time, dental plaque can pick up minerals from your food and saliva, which will cause it to become very hard and difficult to remove. At this stage, it is now called calculus or tartar.
So the aim is to implement a thorough oral hygiene routine to remove soft plaque effectively twice a day before the plaque gets a chance to mature or form calculus. Improving your oral hygiene will reduce your risk of gum disease.
Once dental plaque develops into calculus, it becomes incredibly tough and cannot be removed with at-home toothbrushing. You will need to visit a dental professional who will be able to remove this calculus using special tools.
Unfortunately, more dental plaque can attach to deposits of calculus, which in time turns into even more calculus. So there is an undesirable cycle of bacterial growth which needs to be broken. Remember, the longer plaque and calculus are left undisturbed, the greater at risk you are of developing gum disease. So it's better to see your dentist sooner rather than later.
Gingivitis simply means inflammation of the gums and is a very common condition. A classic sign would be that your gums may bleed easily after brushing your teeth.
Gingivitis is caused by dental plaque, which is a collection of different types of bacteria that naturally grow around your teeth. Your body's natural protective response to these bacteria is the process of inflammation, which causes your gums to become red, swollen, and start to bleed easily.
The good news is that the effects of gingivitis are completely reversible by simply improving your oral hygiene. This is achieved by improving your brushing technique and making sure you regularly remove fresh dental plaque every day. You can either watch our oral hygiene video or go to the oral hygiene section in the My Dental Care app for some great tips to improve your oral hygiene. You should also visit your local dental practice who can help give you tailored advice. If gingivitis is left untreated, in some cases it may lead to full-blown gum disease, also known as periodontitis.
So periodontitis is a destructive form of gum disease where you have loss of bone and gum tissues that surrounds and supports your teeth. The initiator of this is bacteria in dental plaque and your body's natural protective response to these bacteria and their toxins.
The amount of bone and gum tissue that you may lose depends on how long you've had the condition, your risk factors, and your body's natural response to the type of bacteria in your dental plaque. Therefore, this can vary from person to person.
Gum disease is usually painless, which is great. However, this also means it can go unnoticed for a long period of time until the disease is at an advanced stage. If left untreated, you can lose significant amounts of important gum and bone tissue needed to support your teeth, which will result in your teeth becoming wobbly or falling out. This is why it's essential for you to visit your dentist regularly, so they may help to identify, resolve, or slow down the progression of gum disease.
One way a dentist can identify gum disease is by checking your gum pockets. A gum pocket is a space which exists between your teeth and your gums. Your gums are attached to the roots of your teeth, which help support and secure your teeth in place. The gums separate from your teeth just below the crown. This is the top part of your tooth, and this creates a small space called the gum pocket. In a healthy mouth, the gum pocket will usually be between 1 to 3 millimeters deep, and your dentist can detect this using a special probe.
Individuals who suffer from gum disease will have deeper gum pockets more than 4 millimeters due to the destruction of the gum tissue attached to the roots of their teeth. This creates a larger pocket space which can allow more bacteria to grow and multiply. Over time, this leads to more destruction of gum tissue, resulting in deeper pockets and more bacterial growth. Therefore, there is a negative cycle of destruction and bacterial growth which needs to be broken. As this all occurs below the gums, it is very difficult for you to remove this buildup of bacteria by yourself.
At this point, you'll need to visit a dentist or a hygienist who will have special tools to remove the buildup of this bacteria below your gums. This will allow your gums to heal and your gum pockets to reduce in size. If you suffer from gum disease, you will usually need to see your hygienist or dentist quite regularly until these pockets have reduced to a healthy and stable level.
There are quite a few risk factors that can make you more prone to gum disease. The first one is smoking, which can seriously affect both your general and oral health and is linked to many preventable illnesses such as oral cancer, lung disease, and heart disease. Studies have shown that tobacco use is a significant risk factor in the development and progression of gum disease. Smokers tend to have poorer healing response to gum treatment and have an increased risk of disease reoccurrence.
Ironically, smokers' gums may actually appear healthier than non-smokers, even though they may have advanced gum disease. This is because the nicotine in your cigarette reduces the blood flow to the gums, meaning less bleeding and the gums appearing less swollen. However, what this really means is that smokers can be more unaware of gum problems, and it can go undetected for much longer. If you're interested in stop smoking or need any advice, please visit the NHS Go Smoke Free website or call the number on the screen now.
Another risk factor is poor oral hygiene. Having a poor brushing technique will allow dental plaque to accumulate around your teeth. This is the main risk factor which you can change and is a crucial component to all successful gum treatment. All types of dental gum treatment will still rely on you being able to remove dental plaque for the treatment to be successful.
Diabetics tend to have a worse response in regards to gum healing after having gum treatment, which makes treating gum disease in a diabetic person more challenging. The good news is that having well-controlled diabetes is not a risk factor for gum disease. Therefore, by improving your diabetic control, you will effectively lower your risk of gum disease.
Also, the reverse is true, meaning that your gum disease can actually make your diabetes worse by negatively affecting your blood sugar control. Studies have shown that gum treatment can improve your blood sugar control. Therefore, it could have the additional benefit of reducing the risk of diabetic complications.
Another risk factor is stress. At times, we can all become stressed. It may be due to an important event coming up, an exam, or even a simple friendly dental visit. Prolonged periods of stress can lead to suppression of your immune system, which might allow bacteria in your dental plaque to cause more harm to your gum tissue. Also, we tend not to look after ourselves as well as we would normally during times of stress. If you feel this describes your current situation, then it may be helpful to look into some stress management strategies or visit the NHS website on the latest guidelines about stress.
The final risk factor we wanted to mention is genetics. Unfortunately, with gum disease, there is an element of host susceptibility, which essentially means you can be more or less prone to gum disease. This comes down to your genetics and your immune system. Some people are more susceptible than others. However, this shouldn't be your excuse to not change other risk factors, as they all have a part to play.
Now, the best way to help prevent gum disease is to maintain great oral hygiene by using a good brushing technique and a good hygiene routine. The aim is to regularly remove fresh dental plaque on all the surfaces of your teeth before it has a chance to grow and mature. See our oral hygiene videos or the oral hygiene section in the My Dental Care app for some great tips, and visit your local dentist who can give you personalized advice.
After tooth brushing, it may be helpful to occasionally use a plaque disclosing tablet to help identify the surfaces of your teeth which have dental plaque remaining on them and require further cleaning.
Make sure to also clean in between your teeth at least once a day, preferably before going to sleep. Use interdental brushes to clean the spaces in between your teeth. If the contacts between your teeth are too tight, then you should be using dental floss to clean these areas.
You should also try to reduce any relevant modifiable risk factors, for example, by quitting smoking, reducing stress, or improving the control of your diabetes. Your local dentist can regularly assess the health of your gums, help improve your oral hygiene, and can start gum treatment if required.
The first part of gum treatment starts with a patient improving their oral hygiene. All methods of gum treatment rely on the regular home removal of dental plaque in order to be successful. This is why we stress how important it can be to make sure you have a methodical approach at removing dental plaque every day to make sure you have good oral health. Even after visiting a dentist or a hygienist for a good thorough clean, your gums will return to the same state in a matter of weeks if you do not maintain your oral health and your oral hygiene. Therefore, the majority restorative work is actually done at home.
Your dentist or dental hygienist will use special tools to remove the bacteria around your teeth and in your gum pockets. They may need to numb your gums before scaling, as your gums can be sore during and after treatment. Once a dental plaque and calculus have been removed, your gums should begin to heal. With the calculus not being in the way, it can be easier for you to clean your teeth.
Following gum treatment, your gums can begin the healing process as they are not being consistently harmed by the dental plaque and calculus in your mouth. During this time, you will need to prevent the further buildup of dental plaque in order to allow continued healing of your gums. After a certain period of time, your dentist should review the health of your gums. They will then determine how well your gums have responded to treatment and whether you may need further treatment and any adjustments needed in your oral hygiene care. In particular cases, gum surgery may be required or a referral to a gum specialist may be advised.
Unfortunately, in some cases, the gum disease can still progress despite treatment. However, you can always help to drastically slow the progression of gum disease and hold onto your teeth for as long as possible.
The point at which your gums and your teeth meet is called your gum line. Gum recession is when your gum line has moved away from the crown, the top part of your teeth. This exposes the root of your teeth to the oral environment, and this can make your teeth appear longer and become more sensitive.
The roots of your teeth do not have a strong enamel layer covering them, so when exposed to the oral environment, it can lead to sensitivity. There can be a wide variation in sensitivity experienced from person to person. Some people may have completely exposed roots and no sensitivity, whereas others have an intense sensitivity to the smallest of exposures.
Gum disease is the most common cause of gum recession. However, you should bear in mind that gum recession actually is an indicator good healing is taking place after effective gum treatment. Successful gum treatment will usually result in some type of gum recession.
Some people naturally have thin gums, and in these situations, this thin gum is prone to damage from excessive toothbrushing, smoking, or even eating certain hard foods. This type of recession is often inevitable, but is self-limiting and will not lead to tooth loss. Careful brushing using gentle pressure with a soft to medium toothbrush should help to minimize this type of recession.
Gum recession may occur because of orthodontic treatment if the teeth have been moved too far forward. You may naturally have thin gum tissue, and where your teeth have been repositioned, this can lead to gum recession.
During pregnancy, your gums are more susceptible to inflammation and bleeding. This is because of the natural hormonal changes during pregnancy, which make your gums more reactive to dental plaque. This is also called pregnancy gingivitis.
So if you have noticed that your gums are bleeding easily or notice any blood on your toothbrush, it would definitely be worthwhile visiting your local dentist.
Just to note that if you are suffering from morning sickness or vomiting, please do not brush your teeth straight after vomiting, as the acids from your vomit will temporarily soften your enamel. Try to wait at least 45 minutes before brushing your teeth. Otherwise, it could cause abrasive tooth wear. Just rinse your mouth out with water afterwards to help neutralize and wash away the acids in your vomit. You may wish to use a fluoride-containing alcohol-free mouthwash to help freshen your breath.
Thank you for watching, guys. We hope that you found these videos helpful, and be sure to download the My Dental Care app on the App Store and Google Play Store to be able to watch all the videos in this 6-part series.
See you in the next video.